Hello guys, once again welcome back to a new video. This video is going to be about this is the Bajaj Pulsar NS125. Before starting with this video, I would like to thank Sadashiv Pet Bajaj for allowing me to review. Contact details are down in the description. Contact for good deals. Bajaj offers four color options in this NS125. One is the red, orange, gray, and last one is this blue. Personally, I like it, this blue color, very much. It's very attention grabbing and eye seeking. And there are so many differences compared to the Bajaj Pulsar NS200 and 125. The first and most visible change is a paint scheme. Personally, I liked this paint scheme more than the NS200. Now let's start with the detailed walk around. These are the keys of the bike. It has this Pulsar branding on it. And this is the front look. It looks similar to the old NS200. And this is this paint scheme I was talking about. The paint job is very well done. It looks very premium and it's shining very well. This is the front look. In the front, it gets with halogen headlight. This is the halogen headlight. And here we have Bajaj logo. These are the DRLs. And these are the halogen indicators, which are similar to the NS200. And on the mudguard, it has this carbon fiber like finish. And in the front, it gets with a regular suspension, and these are the tires. It doesn't get with ABS, it gets with a disc brake, and the front tire section is 80-100 by 17 inches. It has this blue accents on the alloy, and personally, I like it, the alloy design very well. And in the NS200, we used to get a radiator for liquid cooling, but it's air-cooled engine, and this is the catalytic converter. And this is the crash guard, and overall ground clearance of the motorcycle is 179 mm, and it gets with this kick start. It's been so many days I have seen kick start in premium bikes. And foot pegs are little rear set, similar to the NS200, and it gets with box section swing arm. And overall fit finish of the bike is very well finished. It looks very premium. I like this bike more than the NS200. And this is the monoshock suspension, and it gets with underbelly exhaust. It gets with both a double and a single stand. This is the rear tire. In the rear, it gets with 190 by 19 inches tire, tubeless tires with a drum brake. Disc would be a very good option, and single channel ABS is also missing. These are the tire huggers, which also have a carbon fiber like finish. And this is the rear look. In the rear, it has this dual tone like finish. Here is the NS125 badging. Again, the paint finish is very premium looking. Here are some vents, fake vents, and grab rails, which are very chunky and good to hold. This is the pillion seat. Seat quality is very good, and it's wide enough as well. Two people won't be a problem. Seat is little bit hard. And this is the rear look. This is the tail. I like this tail very much. And these are the halogen indicators. In the rear, it gets with LED lights for the tail light. And this is the sari guard. The rear tire looks very slim. This is the underbelly exhaust I was talking about. And overall wheelbase of the motorcycle is 1353 mm, and it gets with a carbureted engine. This is the button related to it. This is the fuel cutoff button. And here is the 125 badging, which is finished in white color. And this is the look. Let's turn on the motorcycle. It does a full swipe, and on the left it shows all the tail till lights. And here is the Bajaj logo, which is surrounded by a chrome lining. And it is marked till 12,000 RPM. This is the tachometer, and this is the speedometer. Speedometer is digital. It's showing trip A, trip B, and these are the mode and select button. See, it's showing Odo, trip 1, trip 2. It's driven 54 kilometers only. And these are the mirrors, which are wide. And this is the pass switch. Headlight, high beam, low beam, indicator button. Indicator button is very well finished. And this is the horn. Horn is loud enough. And on the right side, it has this kill switch. And this is the kill switch. And this is the ignition on button, which is the self start. And let's hear to the exhaust note. Now we are here on the roads. It gets with a 5-speed gearbox. Let's do a gear test. It has this 1 gear down, 4 gears up system. Let's do a gear test and later then we will do a top speed run. Now I am in the first gear. Let's see how much it does in the first gear. It does the top speed of 33 and now I am in the second. In the second, 64. The gear ratio is very long. I am in the third. In the third, it's doing the top speed of 85. And now I am in the fourth. The gear ratios are very long, means it's revving very easily till 11,000 RPM. In the fourth gear, it does the top speed of 98 kilometers. In the fifth gear, it can easily pass the 100 kilometers mark. And now let's check the top speed. It gets with a 124cc 4-stroke SOHC engine, which is air cooled, and it produces 11 PS of power and 11 Newton meters of torque as well. And this is the top speed. It does the top speed of 117 kilometers per hour without tucking in. We can clock more top speeds with tucking in, but that's not practical. You can't tuck in like everywhere. So that's the top speed. Now let's slow down and let's talk about this bike. As I said, it gets with 11.99 PS of max power at the rate 1850 RPM and 11 Newton meters of max torque at the rate 7000 RPM. So those were the numbers, and now let's talk about the practicality. How is it to ride in real life? Till 2000 to 3000 RPM, it has a slight lag, but after that, which is in the mid range, it's performing very well. Very well in the sense you shouldn't expect so much because it belongs to 125cc segment. By keeping that in mind, it's very impressive. By 11 PS on the road, it's performing very well. But this is not meant for highways, this is meant for city. In the city, it performs very well, but on highways like this, you feel very slow. It does the top speed of 116 kilometers per hour, but you can't clock all day long on the top speed. The cruising speed of this motorcycle is 80 kilometers per hour. This can retain the mileage of around 45 kilometers per liter, and this costs 1,16,000 on road here in Hyderabad. For the NS160, you have to pay 1,40,000. That's 14,000 more than this. And in the same price point, you can even opt for the Pulsar 125, but that won't be a smart choice because the Pulsar design language is very old. But even this NS125's design language is old, but this is more youth oriented. This seems like a good location to click thumbnails. And for a closer look, you can visit my Instagram page. I will upload these photos over there. Photo session is done, and let's check the engine cutoff button if the side stand is down. No, it doesn't has that feature in this. This is the simple motorcycle with minimal amount of tech. And now let's talk about the seating position. You lean towards the handle slightly, and the foot pegs are little rear set, and the seat height is 810 mm, so most of the people can ride it. And now let's check the engine's RPM at the speeds of 70, 80 and 90. Now I am in the speed of 70. The RPM is somewhere around 5000 to 6000 in between that. And let's see how much RPM it does in 80. Now I'm in the 80, it's revving around 8000 RPM. And on the speeds of 90, the RPM is somewhere around 9000 to 10000. So on that speed, you can't clock long distances. It takes so much stress, the engine takes so much stress, and it heats up. It doesn't even have liquid cooling. So on the speeds of 80 or 70, you can cruise all day long. That is the cruising speed of this motorcycle. And let's check the brake. The back brake is good enough, and now let's check the front brake. Brakes have good stopping power, but it doesn't get with any ABS, and in the rear also it has a drum brake, so that's the issue. But brakes have good stopping power and a good response to it, and turning radius is also very good. So on this note, that's it for now guys. Hope you liked my efforts. If you did, like this video and subscribe to my channel. There are more than 97% of viewers who didn't subscribe but yet watching. If you are one of those, please do subscribe and support me.
Oh,